It's such a deep honor to be here today, to celebrate the work we've achieved. Moreover, people like Mrs. Africa and I purposefully didn't prepare anything because I wanted to speak from the heart, but I realized that I might either choke from or wet myself, and I probably those are not great eventualities. You know, besides theatre being available to everyone, it's my idea that it's necessary to everyone. We need to tell our stories, and in a way, that's what the IFP has been doing, is activating people's stories, then telling those stories, and then having people tell their own stories again. So my little contribution is to try to synthesize that in some work that I've done. Two compositions, and the composition of a poem, and really, I want to honor Mrs. Africa, and in a way, my hope is that by doing this, that it honors all of the Mrs. Africas that must have been part of this huge project. Mrs. Africa has been, we know her as Mama Africa, and that's no joke. And Mrs. Africa said she avoided becoming a nurse and a teacher and all those things, but she's lying, because she did all of that. She did all of that in administering all of our fellowships, and we are all deeply grateful, and me possibly more than most, because my mother is also a fellow, and I know for a fact how instrumental Mrs. Africa was in shaping my mother's development to where she is now. She's now stationed in Somalia, based in Kenya, and has been all over the world, Fiji and Liberia and Sierra Leone, doing really, really important work. But more than that, she is the happiest I've ever seen her. She's turned some kind of a major corner that hopefully one day I'll also be able to turn. But the program and Mrs. Africa through the program and the program through Mrs. Africa has been an important part of my life as well, as a father, as a human being, and as an artist. And hopefully I can share that with you today. I'm not a singer, but I'm a storyteller, so. This first piece is called Maskande Waltz, and for those of you who are familiar with South African music, perhaps you'll hear some of the flavors of South Africa. I hope you recognize that. Thank you. This next song is a love song, and the reason why it's a love song is because I believe that is the essence of what we're all doing. And maybe it's not such a bad thing to be reminded of that as often as possible. So this is a love song called The Song of the Basking Lizards. Mrs. Africa, this is for you. A stream of tears winding mischief through the mango trees. She comes a patch of love light coloring the shade.
The light, the shade.